The heart is pretty amazing in that it can continuously beat automatically throughout our entire lifetime. For the average person, this adds up to 2 billion heartbeats. So what exactly is the mechanism behind this autorhythmic contraction of the heart? As previously mentioned, the pacemaker cells of the sinoatrial node are responsible for generating the stimulus for contraction in the heart. Similar to neurons, this stimulus is called an action potential. However, there are some key differences. First, these pacemaker cells generate action potentials spontaneously. No stimulus is required. Next, in addition to involving sodium and potassium ions, calcium ions play a large role in the action potential. Lastly, these action potentials are much slower and last 800 milliseconds on average. So let's take a closer look at the mechanism behind the pacemaker action potential. Like I mentioned, calcium, potassium, and sodium ions play a role in this process. All of these channels are voltage-gated, but they are all slightly different. I've added the ion concentrations in both compartments, so feel free to pause the video at any point to track the flow of ions across the membrane. So let's begin taking a look at the action potential at the threshold, as you can see here. At this point, fast calcium ion channels open, as represented by this blue line, allowing for a relatively quick depolarization until it hits its peak, around 10 to 15 millivolts. Based on what we know about gradients, calcium enters the cell, which explains the depolarization of the membrane. At the peak of the action potential, voltage-gated potassium channels open, and due to the gradient again, potassium leaves the cell, causing a hyperpolarization of the membrane. Now here's where things get interesting. As hyperpolarization occurs, this channel, as indicated by the red line, begins to open. Unlike previous voltage-gated channels, which open due to depolarization, these channels do the opposite, and they open in response to hyperpolarization. This channel is permeable both to sodium and potassium, but predominantly sodium, leading to a slow depolarization as seen here. This then triggers a slower calcium channel as denoted by the green line, and then we're back to where we started with the fast calcium channels opening. All of these unique voltage-gated channels working sequentially are what allows the pacemaker cell to spontaneously fire action potentials. This process repeats itself for all 2 billion heartbeats in a person's lifetime. Now let's take a look at the action potential of the contractile cells in the heart. The initiation of the action potential is much quicker than the pacemaker cells, as the voltage-gated sodium channels allow for a rapid depolarization. At the peak, calcium and potassium channels open. The calcium channel helps to prolong the depolarization as calcium moves into the cell, resulting in this plateau that you see here. This long depolarization provides the necessary stimulus to contract each chamber to expel blood. After about 150 milliseconds, the calcium channels close first, allowing the potassium ions to repolarize the membrane until it reaches the resting potential. At this point, the contractile cell will wait for another incoming stimulus before firing another action potential. Now that we've learned the mechanisms behind the action potential in the pacemaker cells and the contractile cells, let's link this all together. We begin with the pacemaker cells in the sinoatrial node, which has a spontaneous action potential that we saw earlier. This depolarization then spreads to the surrounding cardiac cells. So how exactly does this electrical signal spread? Remember that this electrical signal is carried out by the movement of charged ions. One of the key features of cardiac tissue is the presence of these intercalated discs that contain gap junctions. When an action potential occurs, the positively charged ions enter the cell. These ions can travel from one cell to another through the gap junctions, which triggers the voltage-gated channels in the adjacent cell to fire an action potential. Thus, the action potential can keep traveling from cell to cell throughout the cardiac tissue.